Hey everyone, you're watching Bite Me, and today I have a surprise guest for you. Now this is Chef Pravish, who I have known for like many years, and he's such a great chef. He's head chef of like, I don't even know how many restaurants here in the Middle East, right?
Yeah, but it's been quite a long now.
But it's amazing. You had like a journey all over the Middle East with taking Indian food and bringing it to new tables, right?
Absolutely.
And he's really, really passionate about Indian food.
Yes. I mean, when it comes to Indian food, it's the core Indian ingredients which has always fascinated me. And it's like you take these flavors, elevate it and serve it in the five-star hotels or the fine dining restaurants or the high-end restaurants.
And my kitchen also, like today.
Absolutely.
So today you're going to make a very traditional Mangalorean dish, right?
Absolutely. That's back from my natives. My version, or I can say, like how my mom used to make. There are different versions to the same recipe, but then we can always have, because as you know, Indian food is not defined. My mom makes a different dal than Nicole's mom, of course. So that is how we continue. So here is my version or my mom's version of the fish puli munchi.
What does puli munchi mean?
Basically, there are two factors. It's like khatta, puli for the tamarind, and munchi means the chili, the spiciness.
So the sour and the bite, essentially.
Absolutely. Okay. That is how it goes about.
So we're going to get started in a few seconds.
Yeah, surely. Okay, so when it comes to the fish puli munchi or the basic marination which we're talking about, I mean, it has three components. First is we roast the spices along with the onion and garlic, and then we blend it all together, and then of course we apply to the fish, and the last stage including the grilling with the banana leaf wrapped in it.
That sounds really fancy.
Absolutely. So can we start, Tarang?
Yeah, sure. Surely. I think it's hot enough.
So I'll start off with the spices which are in smaller quantities. First is the fenugreek seeds. I mean, these are very delicate, so just go on very mellow. Try to stir off the pan, that's how. I mean, we also call it in technical terms broiling. I mean, roasting spices without any medium of oil, water or anything. We call it broiling.
I've been doing this for years and I did not know what it was called. That's amazing. And on a low flame, correct?
Yes, on a low flame preferably, because you don't want to take the, especially when cooked, you're cooking roasting spices for the first time, prefer doing it on a low flame. It will ensure you good results.
Yeah, because if you're like me and you like leave it on and take a phone call,
it's
going to burn. Also, I just want to say, when you're doing this, make sure you're doing it with like a spatula.
Yes.
You are not Chef Pravish, you will burn your fingers. So Chef, is there like a key point you're looking for when you're like, you know, roasting the methi seeds or fenugreek?
Fenugreek seeds, the pungency, the smell of pungency, I mean, and the color, of course. I mean, you see, it's a nice brown color, slightly.
So that sharpness in scent.
If you go to see here, it's slight brown and you're getting that pungency. Yeah. So the right time, just get it out.
100%. I will remember for the next time I'm roasting spices.
So next I'll go for cumin seeds.
Okay.
Again, roast it.
And we just wait for this to turn fragrant as well.
Yes.
And then pop it into the bowl.
Absolutely. Okay. The secret with spices is patience.
You, with women also, by the way. Patience.
Yeah, you can see that. See, it's almost getting lightly brown. And I hope our cumin is there.
It smells amazing.
Yeah. Next will be, I'm using carom seeds and mustard seeds together.
Okay, because they're both the same,
this
size essentially.
Yes.
Also remember that the pan is getting considerably hotter as it's like going on. So keep that in mind as well.
Again, when it comes to carom seeds and like ajwain and mustard seeds, again here it's not the color, it's the aroma. It's the aroma, it's the pungent aroma which will make you, will tell you that yes, time to get rid of the bowl.
Okay.
Finally, now we can slightly increase the heat.
Okay.
Because we are going with the stronger spices. Okay, the peppercorns are done. So I can just remove it. And finally, the coriander.
See, people often think like Indian food is not that elegant, but it is. There's so many beautiful little steps. It's like a dance, everything together. It's so nice. So now we're going to start with like the onion and garlic and stuff.
And the dry red chili. This is a good quantity. what we can do here is, we can, I mean, if you're adding like say 15 pieces of dry red chili, the Kashmiri chilies, mm-hmm. we can also replace it with like 50% this one and 50% of the Bedki chilies.
Okay.
The Bedki chilies are much more fiery, they are much more spicy.
So you can adapt it is what you're saying.
You can adapt it as per your level of spiciness preference. You can actually replace the chilies. If on a slow flame, it will take around 5 to 7 minutes at least, if on a slow flame. But then, if it's on a high flame, I won't prefer, but continue it for 5 minutes at least at okay. a low flame. So but like keep on tossing.
This really is patient.
It's patience.
If a boyfriend or girlfriend makes any Indian food for you, remember yes. this person loves you. For sure. And it's nicely roasted
wow.
all over.
This is good. Okay, so yeah. let's remove this. So now is the last thing, which is like roughly warming up the ingredients, mm-hmm. the wet ingredients, is just to give up a little bit of heat, make mm-hmm. it soft, and then we blend it all together.
Okay.
It's just onion, garlic, and curry leaves.
So oh, I start the curry leaves.
Yes, we'll just heat it up. Just saute it, yeah.
And this is also all dry, you don't add any oil to this either.
Don't
right?
add nothing, we don't need any oil. I'll add the curry leaves at the end. Again, the curry leaves, when you go to different markets, you'll find different curry leaves. Some curry leaves are dark green in color. It's a bit stiff. I mean, and some are soft. So it depends on the curry leaf to curry leaf, like that.
Does it impact the flavor though?
A slight bit. I mean, what I've noticed is the darker one, the hard ones, tend to give out more flavors. So
oh.
you can use a reduce lesser quantity.
That's what my curry plant is like. It's got these big, hard green leaves. Can I make this in advance, the paste?
Absolutely. You can make this paste. And what I would suggest to you is make this paste without salt and make some small containers or packets and keep it in your deep freezer.
Yes.
Yeah, this is fine enough. It's just got softened enough and the curry leaves also are cooked. We are getting the combination mm-hmm. aroma. Now we can take all together and blend it with tamarind and a hint of turmeric.
All right, so that's what the tamarind water is for.
Yes, we have soaked the tamarind nicely. It's soft. We have used the black tamarind. There are two, three different versions of tamarind. We got the brown tamarind, if you've seen, which are pretty big.
Yeah.
And these are the ones which are a bit in the paste form.
Yeah, they're sticky.
The black ones,
yeah.
sticky. So these ones are good. I prefer, as a chef, I prefer to use these dark tamarind, the black ones for the South Indian cooking, and the brown ones for the Northern Indian cooking, like imli ka chutney for our chaats. Yeah, you can make it well with the brown one.
Okay.
Yes.
So now I just blend this with a little bit of turmeric and...
And a little tamarind and water.
Okay, we shall be right back with that then. So this is the paste that we're looking for, right, Chef?
Absolutely. Smooth and nice and thick so that when you apply on the fish, it holds on.
Okay.
If it's too liquidy, what will happen is it will flow out. And if it's too thick, it will break off. And it will burn.
Oh, and also you want a really nice fine paste, okay? So it took me a while to do this, but you want this really nice smooth consistency because you said if it's grainy, it's going to burn
it's
faster.
It's going to burn the spices.
Okay, see important things you learn from proper chefs. Okay, so next we're just going to marinate our kingfish, correct, Chef?
Absolutely. I mean, what I've done is just before roasting the spices, I've given a simple basic marination for a seafood. I mean, we go put lime juice, some turmeric and some salt. So what happens is when you add the second marination, it seeps in, the flavor goes in. So when you eat the fish, you don't have flavors just dancing on the surface. It is right through the meat. So
there are lots of restaurants I'm going to take you to and you can tell the chef this, okay? Where they've given me just flavor only on the top and I've been sad. So now, Chef, we're just going to add this to
yes,
our kingfish sticks.
To
right?
our kingfish sticks.
Okay.
Okay, so here is a good amount of marination. Let me apply it. If you see, it's holding on the fish nicely.
Ooh.
Make sure it's evenly spread all through so that what happens is you will not miss out on the flavors on any part of the fish.
Mm-hmm.
So what we'll do is now we leave this fish in the marination for say about an hour.
Okay.
So what happens is the flavors can seep in and when we come back, we'll be ready for grilling.
We will go to the beach and see you in 3 to 4 hours.
Bye-bye.
We're back from the beach. It's been 4 hours.
Absolutely.
So now, Chef, you're going to wrap them in banana leaves, correct?
Yes, the fish is nicely marinating, swimming in its red marination. And let me give it some nice clothing on top so
Aww.
That we can start cooking it.
That's so nice. And then it's such a scary ending.
Okay, we place it here.
Okay.
I've just cut the banana leaf stripwise so that it can. Why the banana leaf? I'm sure many must be thinking. It not only allows the flavor of the banana leaf itself, considering it's a coastal food, but also it holds on the spices. It doesn't allow it to burn.
Okay.
So I'll take some extra marination, apply it so that we get enough flavors.
Also, you're not applying any fat or any oil, nothing extra
absolutely
is being
not
added. So technically, this is quite healthy.
Yes.
And this is green, so it's a
yes
salad. Yes, chef.
I wish that could be the logic everywhere. Okay, so one is ready. You want to try the second one?
Yes.
Sure.
This will be like the most work I have done
please
today. Also, chef, what did you do with the banana leaves before you folded it?
I just happened to keep it on a bit of heat so that it gets softened and it doesn't tear off.
Okay. So on a hot pan or like on the stove itself?
As home cooks, I would not suggest that. It's a bit risky putting it directly or you might burn your hands. So rather keep a hot pan aside and just press it on the pan. Like just press your palm on the banana leaf. It will make it soft.
A plus?
Perfect. Perfect. She's done actually better than me. I envy her.
I didn't want to say so, but the chef said it. So we'll come back and we'll fry these, right, chef?
Yes.
Okay. So you need a nice pan for this, correct?
Absolutely. And Nicole has actually gifted me something really good. This is a cast iron. And thanks to the amazing kitchen edition, she has got this beautiful vessel. I mean, the best part about cast iron is it retains heat for
of
a long
course
time. I mean, I've not seen many people using this at home, but...
I'm old school like this. So,
classics.
Chef, like you were saying, zero oil.
Yes, and that's how it'll go about. I mean, what I've done is here, I've deleted the oil. I mean, why do you need oil? You have got such a beautiful banana leaf, wrapping it, emitting its flavors into the seafood. You got the nice marination, you put in all the hard work. Let's continue to keep it healthy. So I'll take the first bit of fish, probably the thicker version, thicker one. I'll place it right here.
Okay.
You won't, when you put it like this, without any medium of heat, what
no
happens
idea
is you'll miss that tempering, yes, sizzling flavor, the sound of it, but you'll gradually get it.
Like I'm sure you all can hear that as well right now. You can hear the banana leaf reacting to the heat of the pan.
Yeah. And gradually you'll see the juices of the fish coming out and rendering the heat through the like vapors coming out and making it much more flavorful.
So we do this on a medium to low heat, correct?
Medium to low heat because that's perfect. Because of the thickness of the fish, you keep it medium to low. If it's a thinner slice, then I would keep it medium.
Okay.
I would keep it medium.
So roughly how long do you think these will take to cook?
This will take around like say 8 minutes
okay
to 10 minutes to cook because I'm preferring a medium to low, it'll take a bit longer to cook.
Can I do this on a barbecue?
You can definitely, but then the challenge would be to holding the banana leaf, you might have to truss it.
Okay.
It, I mean you have to use a thread which you generally use to tie up turkey or chicken. You can use that.
Kitchen string and stuff,
yes,
yeah,
and you can just tie it up. You can see the juices flowing out.
Yeah.
And it will be more and more.
So just bubbling out at the end?
Yes.
So when do we know that like we have to put the lid on?
A bit more because I'm waiting for the fish to get hot enough so that once the fish overall is hot enough, I'll put the lid.
It smells so good.
Yeah, now you're getting the aroma.
Oh my God, it smells fabulous. And you're right, the banana leaf does make like an aromatic difference as
yes
well.
You can cover it now.
Okay.
So after spending like around 3 to 4 minutes on one side, now it's I think time to flip it over.
Okay. So you can actually see like the leaves have kind of broken down a little
yes
bit, right?
So we just flip it over. Wow.
It's so nice that it's a healthy dish.
Yes, it's absolutely no oil, no fat at all.
Cover again?
Yeah. You want to feel the aroma once?
Like if someone proposed to me like this, like, oh my God, instant marriage. Oof.
Okay, coming back to the cooking, the doneness of the fish. Since it's a kingfish and it's easy, it's more or less like a steak to understand. You just touch it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's raw and it's done. But also kingfish can continue.
So this
continue
is done, correct?
Yes, absolutely. A bit, hold it like this, yeah.
So the firmer it is, because
yeah
this is the firmest part
yeah
of your hand when you're doing that.
Well, let us check.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes.
So it's done, right?
Fish is almost done. It's time to remove it. We
okay
can check. It's soft. See?
So this feels just perfect to
perfect
me, actually.
Absolutely.
All right. So now we're going to get ready to eat.
Yes, you'll get the nice moisture of the spices which has cooked with the banana leaf and the fish.
Oh, it smells so nice.
And this one, what about the this dish? I mean, this dish, we can have it as it is when you, I mean, you enter a house, I mean, your guests have just entered, you can give them as a bite.
Like an appetizer.
And also we can serve it with our simple dal chawal. Wow, I love it. Dal chawal and...
That's rice and dal for those who don't speak chawal.
Yes. That's like our home meal. With that, this goes amazingly well. And the third thing is for our friends who love to have some hard drinks. This is something spicy and some chilled drinks.
I am perfect. That friend. Bring me alcohol and... Okay, so let's go and taste.
Let's go and taste.
So all my dreams have come true.
Absolutely. So the slow, gentle method will now blast in your mouth.
Okay. It's also just like fun undoing the whole thing, right?
Yes.
Ooh, you can smell it. Oh, and it's perfectly cooked.
Yes, looks like.
Look, it's all flaky and beautiful.
Is it?
It's puli munchi. That's exactly what it is.
Is it?
That sour,
yeah.
And a little hit of heat.
Yes.
It's beautiful, it's yummy. It's like you said, with dal and rice.
Yes, this would be ideal.
Ideal, I think we should just make dal and rice next
or
time.
Or a mug of beer.
Mug of beer. No, dal, rice, mug of beer.
And
puli munchi.
Perfect.
So chef is not eating his, which means for me.
I will try to grab a few, but I've done it many times. That's the reason.
Like I'm saying, this is my dream come true. You've come to my house and you've cooked me some food.
Thank you. That's what friendship is all about.
Thank you, chef.
Thank you.